if you are helping people, if you are giving, if you are a giver, you become very fast. You can build your brand very, very fast. If you see any of my content, you will figure out that most of my content doesn't sell. They educate. It is for other people to understand. So that's the fundamental of building a content of personal branding.
This is a topic that we'll be focusing on. And to discuss this and inspire you guys, I've invited Shubhabroto Chakrabarty. Shubhabroto is one of the best creative minds I've been following on LinkedIn for quite some time. He's the founder of The Digital Fellow, a premium business consulting firm that helps businesses get online. He has over 27 years of experience and has managed over 120 industries in more than 34 categories. He has been a keynote speaker in many events, including the World Marketing Summit 2020. He has been awarded the Digital Influencer of the Year 2019 award and also the Top 100 Smartest Digital Marketer award. Apart from this, Shubhabroto is also a jury at APAC MMA, that is Mobile Marketing Association. Along with that, he is also a jury and advisor at ASEF Global and Asian Forum Awards. He likes to talk about digital marketing, personas, and sometimes likes to bust myths on digital. He also writes a weekly fun column on Exchange for Media called Why So Serious? I'll stop with the introduction now because believe me, I can keep on going. So let's welcome Shubhabroto to the LinkedIn podcast.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Shubhabroto. Thank you so much. Thanks for inviting me. Invitation. I'm really thrilled to have you here. How are you doing?
Thank you so much. I'm good. Thank you so much. In fact, I'm really happy. I think after a lot of podcasting and a lot of Zoom session, I think there was a gap. So because of Bombay, where I live in, is also in a very bad condition. So I think your session hopefully will be an interesting one for my viewers as well as your viewers also.
Yeah, I'm hoping for this thing, this particular objective. Yeah.
Yeah, true.
Okay, so now let's talk a bit about building a personal brand, which is the topic today. So how does one go about building it? Is there a process that one can follow?
See, very simple, I realize, yes, sir. You can use any platform to build yourself. But please understand, please ask yourself, will you hire yourself? Question number one. Will you hire yourself? Do you have that amount of knowledge? Do you have that much of information? Do you have that much of conviction? Do you have so much of experience? Imagine if you have an experience, you want to articulate into your, you know, in some form of a content. It can be a video, it can be a post, it can be quote, whatever. If you don't have the credible to make a content, then it becomes very difficult for people to, to pay for the content, right? So this is an issue. So I'll tell you, if you don't have credible information and knowledge, if you don't have anything to share, imagine you don't have experience, you don't have great experience to share, and you don't have knowledge, you should first learn, understand, and give your views and convert that views into your content. Rule number one for making a personal branding. Okay. Next is that, why do you need personal branding? You need to get attention from the corporate. You need to get attention from the journalist. You need to get attention for the top schools to hire you to speak or as a forum, right? So you should talk something meaningful. You should talk something helpful. You should talk something which benefits other. It is nothing to do with you. It is to do with them. It is for everything which is outside. So if you are helping, if you are, it's what we know as a Hindu is that karma. If you are helping people, if you are giving, if you are a giver, you become very fast. You can build your brand very, very fast. If you see any of my content, you will figure out that most of my content doesn't sell. They educate. It is for other people to understand. So that's the fundamental of building a content of personal branding. Please give first. If you have to be a giver first, then only you can build a content. And to give, you need to have a knowledge and experience so that people understand, value your suggestions, and then they remember you. And then they later end up hiring you or, whatever, engage with you, okay, and so on and so forth.
Great. All right. So any three tips that you have to make your brand stand out on LinkedIn especially?
Okay. I think for LinkedIn, the most important part is that it's very professional site. It's a platform. People are serious here. Make sure you make them give so much of information they feel value about it. It should be about, three things if I tell you is that, one, immense amount of value, immense amount of tricks or shortcuts or experience you have been going through, pure value is what what you should do.
All right. So give value and build your personal brand. That's how you, you know, stand out with this, you know, huge number of people on LinkedIn. All right.
Right.
So I'm very curious that why do you use LinkedIn? What are your top two objectives of using LinkedIn?
First is that if you're looking for an attention from the corporate world, if you're looking attention from the, you know, organized, you know, sector, I think LinkedIn is the best place to be in. Because other people, because when you come to a LinkedIn, your sense of you know, engagement level is different. When you joined, even when you join, when you come to a Facebook, your mental state is different. So if you want to have that set of people who are serious, who's looking for some food for thought, who're looking for information, valuable information, and they're watching what is happening in the ecosystem. So hence LinkedIn is important. So the two way of, let me give you a very simple example. When you get a newspaper, Times of India in Bombay, you know, I'll give you my example. Which paper first you pick up? Do you pick up a business? Do you pick up page 3 where you talk about, pick up celebrity? Or you first read the first page? So it's a choice. So you have to, you know, make yourself available in that part where you want to build your genre. Like if you want to be in a profession, has to be in LinkedIn.
Why are you on LinkedIn? So why do you use it?
Okay, fine. For me is that I want to attract corporate people. Okay. So that business generation happen. In fact, let me give an example to answer this question. 90% of my business come from LinkedIn.
Wow.
90.
Okay.
Another second rule. I have not spent anything marketing on LinkedIn. My spends on LinkedIn is zero. Z-E-R-O. Zero. I have not spent a single money on zero. Everything happens on organic growth. Organic. 100% organic. And I have been responding to people whenever they look for help at any point of time. My response time is not even more than 5 minutes. Even this 1 o'clock at night, I always respond. Mm-hmm. And it's a very explanatory. So there's a huge, I think 34,000 people are following me and around some 35,000 people who are on my LinkedIn channel. So 60,000 people is needed in the system. It took me some 10 years time to reach here, but based on one thing, absolutely value. Because when I was also working, I was also contributing, right? It was also contributing. So I think that's the important part. So I'm on LinkedIn to get business. I'm on LinkedIn to get found. I'm on LinkedIn to get, so another advantage of getting on LinkedIn is that Google SEO helps you. So you can track. If you search your name, you will find Shubho. If you just write, do one thing. If you write, you know, just write Shubho, not even Shubho Broto. Google will tell you, are you looking for Shubho? Because that is the reason. I mean, LinkedIn is a friendly to SEO. It helps.
Yeah, so I'm really amazed that 90% of your business comes from LinkedIn, that too without spending a dime on marketing. So that's the power of LinkedIn.
Zero, right?
You have to be on LinkedIn to grow your business if you want to save money. Because LinkedIn is rewarding organic content right now, right? There's no other platform like it. So I see you posting a lot of quirky and fun stuff apart from, you know, informative posts. How does this content strategy translate into your personal brand?
Okay, fine. So I've created some 4 or 5 different types of genres of brand of content. One content is a serious content which goes as a blog, pure blog, where education. Another content which goes on a video where I go out and speak in different forum. I convert that into a you know, video format and put it on a video. Second is what I use, that I use lots of content on international days, right? What is happening today? So then I link that with a digital thing. So fourth and fifth is where I you know, we are following influencer series. So we are actually telling these are the 20 people, 100 people, 500 people you should follow if you want to be in digital. Second series that we give advices to the CXO. The problem I face is what I give. It's a CXO series all about educating the CXO of the world, the things you should know if you want to be a, you know, CMO or a CXO of the world. Things you should know, otherwise you will not be able to manage. So CXO. Next is a series which is a not my content series, where I actually put, you know, I'm a curator. I don't create content. I pick up the best of the content which suits into a LinkedIn you know, profile or a persona, and use it to get attention to a little bit of humor. Sixth is that, which is a lot of things coming, you know, digital learning from mythology, digital learning from Gita, digital learning from food habits, digital learning from superheroes, digital learning from, you know, Supermans, right? So all these are coming. And digital learning from fables. What you can learn from Pied Piper. Digital learning you can learn from, you know, Red Riding Hood. all these things are coming. So my spray and the array or the bandwidth of contents are different. So by doing this, I will be able to attract different phases and different stages of the nature of people. So if you're a student, if you're an advanced guy, if you're a digital guy, if you're a tech guy, if you're a scientific guy, if you're a podcaster, if you anything, whoever you are, some or the other way, we have food for you. So yeah. So this is the reason I built my content, so I get attraction. So I think most of the colleges, 60 colleges have gone there. I mean, I've been teaching as a faculty. I have never applied to any college. I was teaching for Indore. I'm Indore for last, I think, 4 years. I'm Kashipur happened recently. IIT Kharagpur happened recently. Not a single place I've applied. I get found. I get discovered by the students of the authority, and they see my content. The beauty of LinkedIn should be, or any content should be, if someone scroll your profile for 4 to 5 times, five scroll, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 times. People should know what you do, why you do, how you do. If you answer these 3 questions without talking through your content, you will be able to build your brand.
Yeah.
Or business or anything else.
I find it really interesting that you take inspiration, digital inspiration from so many things. I'm sure that no one else is taking inspiration from mythology, Pied Piper.
No, no,
yeah,
no. That's you awesome. Can Google, you will not find a single content.
Yeah. So that's why you are the digital fellow, right? Okay. Yeah.
So I use metaphor, I use metaphor. I use lots of metaphor to make a non-digital guy fall in love with digital.
Yeah.
This is quite a risk. It's a very difficult thing. COVID has been an amazing thing happened in the world. I think there's a good part of COVID is that a lot of digital transformation has happened.
Yeah.
The mindset has happened. Yeah. Thousands of the companies are shut down because all the traditional people who are holding themselves saying, no, I don't want digital, sales tradition is what I've been doing for the last 20 years. This will not affect. They got a slap on their face. They got a thrash on their nose. I think this has happened. I think that's an amazing thing. So that is the reason you need to educate, shake them up, wake up people who are still sleeping. COVID has done what I could not do for the last 2 years.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, since we are talking about COVID, these are surely difficult times, right? So how you have been able to capitalize on this digital transformation that you just spoke about, and what role has LinkedIn played in that?
Sorry, once again.
I was asking that in this digital transformation, how you have been able to capitalize that, and what role has LinkedIn played in this entire digital transformation for you?
Okay. See, I will not take the benefit of the advantage that I'm doing something great now. I have been doing it for the last 3 or 4 years time. So digital is one place where if you come occasionally and show up, algorithm doesn't treat you well. If you are seen every day, 2 to 3 times, every single day, if you show up, algorithm will start showing your content to many, many more people. And the probability of you getting found is 1,000 times better. So I'll give you an example. You will get a shock if I tell you the number of content which goes every day around 180 to 200 content generally goes out from Digital Fellow to the outside world in different channels. Okay. 200, right? So it's not that 200 unique, but at least 10 or 15 unique rest into like in LinkedIn, we go to 15, 20 groups. Okay. On Facebook, we have some 20 groups like that. So around 200, which means 76,000 content get published from Digital Fellow.
Wow.
76,000 content, even on Sunday, it goes out. So what happens? When you spray so much of content, meaningful content, helpful content, it doesn't sell anything. It's not selfish content. It's a helping content, right? You help, right? You motivate. You tell them the tricks. You educate them. You change their mindset. If you're giving so much, so this is what inbound marketing teaches you. It's like a karma. What gives out comes in. If you're educating so much, doesn't matter whether you're on LinkedIn or you're in any channel, you will definitely grow. Yeah. Second is that if you ask me that how LinkedIn is helping me, as I said, 99% of the business come from LinkedIn, and 99% of the business who comes to me, I don't know them. They're all strangers. Which means I could pull them from a no need stage to consideration stage to decision stage with the help of my content.
Yeah.
Imagine you and me are strangers 20 weeks, 2 weeks back, or 3 weeks back. So you and me are right now talking, and you invited me in your show to talk, is not because you knew me, right? So who did the trick? It's not me who did the trick. It's my content who has made you push, let me call and reach out to this guy. Yes. And my content has been hitting you constantly for a longer period of time. So in your mind, you have also gone through the funnel. So you first were aware of Shubhabrata, then you started considering Shubhabrata, then you started deciding let's call Shubhabrata. And here we are right now talking after 2 weeks. Before, I mean, 2 weeks back, strangers. Now we are friends. I'm your guest absolutely. On your podcast. So,
yeah, absolutely.
So that's how it works.
Yeah, I completely agree. And I've been able to connect with people, so many people, so many, you know, interesting and informative people through LinkedIn, just like I've been in touch with you. Okay. So yeah, when we talk about brand on LinkedIn, we also should talk about the company side, the company brand, right? So how does LinkedIn help in that, and why is LinkedIn better than other platforms for company branding?
See, apart from LinkedIn, you don't have any other channel where corporates are very, attached, right? So I think only social channel for corporate is LinkedIn. So other than, so Facebook pages, people, if you go to any Facebook pages of any corporate, you will find what HR is doing, how they're cutting cake on 15th August, these pictures you'll get. But you will not get much of, you know, it's because that's the place, because that fits into that amount of culture. But LinkedIn is the only place, fewer places like Quora is important. Quora is very, very important. Quora is a place where real conversation happens, real question answer happen. No one goes to Quora if you're not interested.
Yeah.
And the third one, which is not used much in India by the corporate, is a Twitter. Twitter handle or Twitter is a place where not much corporate are very highly active. So I think since if you don't count Twitter and Quora, I think LinkedIn is the only choice you have. You have no other option.
Yeah, and I also feel that you can reach directly to company, you know, management or company people through LinkedIn very effectively. There's no other platform like that which connects you directly.
No other platform.
Absolutely. So and in this past 4-5 months, how this company strategy with respect to LinkedIn, have you seen change? How have they changed their strategy on LinkedIn?
I think you're talking the corporates, right?
Yeah, corporates. Yes.
I think corporates, I published 2 or 3 content on how corporates are helping during COVID. It's called, how you're reaching out, how you're, many corporates are coming and helping. There's a lot of donation happened, a lot of, kit which companies are buying. And then a lot of support, sanitization, all those things, food, everything goes out. So I will not say it's a CSR activity.
Yeah.
Companies are more empathetic towards the scenario, peers, employees. So, but it happened on the first part of the lockdown, or the first two months. Gradually, it's a big blow on the corporate because your office is closed. You cannot sell. You have to lay off. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people are getting laid off. And the senior people are getting laid off. I mean, so that's a little bad part what happened. So that is the time I think many corporates are helping, like Zomato has figured out, is that they are marketing their people who want to lay off, They're telling these are 20 people, best team we have, do you want to hire? So that these are all empathetic things which top brands are doing. I think not much people are doing. In fact, most of the time, I think many corporates are right now silent. I think this is an amazing time where you can also market yourself, not typically selling your products or services, but helping and enthusiasm, or maybe, empathetic towards your people, is also a great brand building opportunity, which I am also doing. I think I don't see much for Indian brands, but big brands are doing. Zomato, I still remember just off the end. They're helping people to get hired whom they want to lay off, let go, right?
Yeah.
Because of Oyo, I think.
Yeah. And it's a fantastic opportunity to showcase your company culture as a whole. Right,
yes,
just like you mentioned,
yes,
Zomato.
Yes.
Zomato now with the maternity leaves and whatever news they are bringing in terms of employee, employee centric policies that they are coming up with.
Right.
Shows the company culture, and LinkedIn is a fantastic way to showcase that.
Yes. Yeah, you can actually see COVID will go in next 1 year, 2 years time. But the beauty is that you will get you will never get this opportunity to market yourself.
Yeah.
People will never knew what you did in the worst time. I think it's a great opportunity to be right now. I mean, not being silent and being very focused.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
So coming to the few myths in digital marketing, especially on LinkedIn, can you bust those myths? A few myths here.
Okay, I think that one other content which I never shared is I missed out, is that not equal to. The series called Not Equal To. Digital is not equal to lead generation. There are a lot of misconception and, you know, things which a traditional guy thinks. So I get angry. So out of this content happened because of my anger. We say, I see whenever I talk to any founder, is that once they talk about digital marketing, they say, okay, well, when can I start the lead? Lead happened in the last stage of the funnel. It doesn't happen at the top of the funnel. So these are issues. So I think lead generation is something, nothing to do with digital. It's a part of a digital. Content writing is not copywriting. They're two different aspects, right?
Yeah.
A web developer cannot do a user experience job. Two different skills, right? A UX artist and a BTP operator who do a design and who buy a theme and make it are not the two same people. They are two different people. Right. And content, what you write content is not content. There are process of writing a content. So content becomes a problem. People don't understand content marketing. And, so most people think that I have a Facebook page, I have a YouTube page, I have a website. So that's digital. That's not digital. So if you boil water in your kitchen, that doesn't mean you're a chef.
Yeah.
Boiling water is not cooking. So these are lots and lots of myths. So myth busting happens through my series, which says not equal to. Another thing is that, you know, website is not a website. Website, most people don't understand what is a responsive website, what is a, you know, optimized website. Most of the websites are optimized. They're not web enabled. You're not able to see.
Yeah.
If you see any website, if you have to see any website with the help of more than one thumb, then it's not an active website. It's an optimized. Most of the website need to, you know, zoom out with your two fingers.
Mm-hmm.
So these are issues which I speak on my not equal to series. Please follow that.
So if you could just share the link with me, I would be happy to put that description in the show notes after the episode.
I'll do that.
Yeah.
I'll do that. Right.
Great. I'm sure users would be learning this, enjoying this episode a lot. I'm learning.
Yeah, I made it in a fun manner.
Yeah.
I do it in a fun manner so that you're learning because digital is very complex. It's very complicated. It's very huge. Because people think it's very easy. Because people think I have a YouTube channel. It's like, I keep saying this quote that it says that you have a DSLR, so you're a photographer.
Mm.
I have a pen, which means I'm an author.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So what have been your biggest LinkedIn success stories? If you can share one or two, and if possible, I would like to know a little bit about your failures as well, if you've encountered any on LinkedIn.
I will not say fail. Let me talk about the failure first, then I'll go to the success part.
Okay.
Failure, I'll not say. I think initially when I started posting my content, 5, 10, 15 people used to watch.
Okay.
Because I was not consistent. As I said, if you're an occasional guy, in any platform, it doesn't work.
Hmm.
You have to be constant. The consistency is the thing, which is important. But single guy, before I started my company, it was very difficult to churn out content all alone together. I mean, yourself. You need a team. So right now, we have a team for the last 3 years. So my content ratio and consistency has gone up. It's very stable right now. It was not so when I was alone, pushing this, building this brand. So I'll not say failures. It's a time. I mean, we could do it. I couldn't do it. Advantage is that I get picked up by corporates. Recently, World Trade Center approached me. You get found, actually. The corporates are finding me. The great top colleges are finding me. Corporates are looking for me and saying, okay, come and speak. You get paid for when you speak, right?
Mm-hmm.
So right now, since I'm away from job, so opportunity comes business. 90% of business comes from LinkedIn.
Okay.
And LinkedIn become a showcase. You don't need to see a portfolio once they go to your page. Also, very interesting part to make your personal branding. How do your page look like? How do the images look like? I've seen many DP of LinkedIn where someone is holding a dog, someone is cheering up with a cup of coffee or or a champagne. You know, some dog's pictures are mostly common on LinkedIn. So will you hire who is he? I mean, corporate is hiring a dog or you? I mean, it's strange. I mean, these are funny. People don't even know. And lots of stupid content like Jai Mata Di. I'm not an atheist, but I'm saying no one wants to see a Jai Mata Di content on a LinkedIn. That's a good morning. Doesn't make sense. So people are not aware. So these are the reason I got angry and I started feeling this, not equal to this. Hitting them hard to teach them what you're doing are all stupid and nonsense. Please listen to this and don't do this mistake. So.
Okay. Yeah, keep being angry so that we keep seeing that good quality content. Okay. Yeah. So lastly,
Geeta is coming. I hope. Geeta is coming. I hope that will attract a lot of people.
Okay.
What Arjun and Sri Krishna talk spoke to each other. What are the learnings? Digital learning as a metaphor, you can learn and use it on a digital. And food is coming. What food you should not eat with that food, you know? Food poisoning happening. Same thing if you do the same mistake on digital. So using a lot of metaphor to make you understand a food habit, you know, things you should not eat, like, you know, fish and dahi you should not have. Same thing. What is it that you, so that you remember my story, you remember my education. So metaphor helps.
I'm envying those people who get to attend your lectures in those colleges, because during my MBA days, if I had a professor like you, I would have learned even more than what I did. Yeah, that's really great. So lastly, any parting advice that you give to young professionals or aspiring entrepreneurs, how they can leverage LinkedIn? Any parting advice?
I think a few things is that first, before jumping into a platform, understand the platform. You should, if you see there are 20 people, spot the 20 top people whom you aspire to be. Go to their LinkedIn, see what the content is, read about LinkedIn thing. There are a lot of YouTube video which teaches how LinkedIn. First, you understand it. Don't jump and don't start posting without knowing how it works, right? And see each thing, where how bios are written, how images they're using, what type of content they're writing. Are you commenting on the comments when people are saying? Are you a part of different groups? Do you actively spend time on LinkedIn learning how the groups are talking? You know, how people are responding? Do you follow 20 people or 100 people who are the people whom you think they will teach you more than books or your college? So if you have to be very aware of what you're doing. You have to consider that you should be a very, first empty yourself, the most important part. People jump into LinkedIn because you have 20 years experience and 15 years. You think, I've been a vice president, I understand LinkedIn. No, you don't understand LinkedIn. Mm-hmm. Definitely, you don't understand LinkedIn. You know, so this ego kills them. And that is the reason they chase, because LinkedIn is not a place where you get followers so easily. LinkedIn is not a place where your content get even, liked or, an engagement is more than even 100, right? So to do that, you need to and for most important time, what time of the day you're posting, if it is constantly coming, it's an algorithm. Algorithm doesn't understand beauty or whatever. Algorithm only understand one thing, whatever channel, is that, is your content valuable? Is your content liked and engaged by anyone else? If it is engaged and liked by the user, it will start showing. Also make sure, one most mistake, don't take your user from LinkedIn to any other channel. So if you post anything on YouTube link on a LinkedIn, which means you're taking him away from LinkedIn. LinkedIn algorithm will not like it. So post that video within the LinkedIn so that he can see and consume the content without leaving LinkedIn. That's what algorithm wants you to do. So I think these are the few things, if you follow, then you will be able to build your content.
Yeah. So guys, as Shubhabroto rightly said, focus on the LinkedIn algorithm and good things will happen. So that brings us to the end of today's episode. Thanks, Shubhabroto, for all the information and great insights. I learned a lot today. And I hope the viewers and listeners take away something and put that information to use, practical use. And you can find and follow Shubhabroto on LinkedIn at The Digital Fellow. I'll be sharing the link to his profile in the description. You should definitely follow his content if you want to learn.